So guys, welcome back to another video, or you can say the vlog of Bros Together. So this is the first vlog after the big announcement that was made by a channel that we are announcing drone project. So we announced the drone project, and now the first stage was to order the components, but that wasn't a suitable vlog for us. So we now have the PCBs ready. So I'm just gonna make you introduce to the PCBs. So the PCB was ordered from the JLC PCB. That's a factory in China. And PCB stands for printed circuit board. So we ordered this from my account, so we can see the order history. We can just go to order history. So that is coating is very easy. They just offer a two-layer proper prototype for $2. This one cost me a $7.30 because it has a custom design, where this cost me around $2, total $9, plus they took almost double the shipping charges, that is a $26 plus thousand rupees, that's around 12 or 13 dollars. So that was an additional cost. So I'll tell you, I'll change the camera view to the calculator and tell you what exactly it cost me.
So yeah, I was telling about the calculator view. So we have here the calculator, and this is on which we are now actually recording. So first of all, that was a total $26.28 into. So we can just check the current rate of dollar. So let me just check INR to dollar. Wait, not dinar, it's INR to USD. Thank you. So we have, USD to INR. Sorry guys. So that's around 74. So we can just into 74.64, right? That comes to 1,906.15 plus 1,000 rupees just for the custom that FedEx charged me. So that around comes for total PCB including shipping and custom, for because it was the first time that I had customs, or maybe they every time charge this. But that's too absorbent, I mean too high. So it took me 2,000 rupees. So it's okay, right? They said $2 for just manufacturing, right? Shipping to India from China is like in these lockdown plus FedEx, so like its costs are high. But I had even $9 for those, 7.3 for the other one. So this cost me. So that's it. We'll move on to the another phase of unboxing. So keep tuned in. So don't go. I'm just changing my camera view. Thank you.
So as we shift back from the view, so I just set it the background. So we'll start the unboxing now. I just put the camera a little big so that you can see what I unbox. So the first, this package is like, you can see this, right? So this big was the package. It's like one and a half span, and it's just half a kilogram. So we'll just unbox it with this knife. So this is the FedEx packaging right now above it. So we'll just remove it, and actually it had come from a foreign country or from outside, so we had quarantined it, so it was a little late. I think it was delivered back 3 to 4 days, but due to the coronavirus. And yeah, there's a big news that the Russian government has announced the launched and they signed up for the vaccines. That's a great news. So this is how it came out. There's a blue thing inside. So I just remove this cover. So finally, what I wanted was this box. So this box is a great thing, and I'll just switch the camera view different.
So as we switch the view, you can see the JLC PCB for faster PCB prototypes. And then this is the box. This is a very good box. And it says this up. So I'll just unbox this. So guys, I'll just pause it. So I think the tape was cut open somewhere, but they had used a very broad tape. So it might be a very big task for us to open. Maybe it was open for the customs check. So this was the first layer, they had bubble wrap, and then oh my god, they had sealed it. I think they have opened it because there are a lot of scratches on it. I mean, maybe they had come in the shipping. But yeah, the overall quality I can see is good. So this was the first pack, they turned out to be good. And the second pack, I think this pack, I don't know why, they gave it in this, maybe the this was a prototype, so they have a special pack. The one with this, it's like sealed wrapped. Oh my god, this is compressed wrapping. So this is a very good packing indeed. And then there's this. So they do not actually want their customers. I mean, see this, I'll see some people say China is good, some people say China's bad. See, one thing I say, China sometimes cheats, but yeah, in services and servicing, it is very good. Like I'll not like to comment on this, or maybe no starting race or competition who's better. But yeah, the amount of quality may differ, but yeah, service is overall good of this company. And this is so I would not like to comment, but yeah, I'm just telling because there's a lot of troll coming. I mean, a lot of talks that India is good, this is good, China is betrayer. So I like to say that this is very good. So I'll now change the camera view and we can go on for the webcam.
So returning onto the webcam, we have this package, you can see. So I'll just this has a cut here, bubble wrap. I think this customs have actually opened the whole thing, but yeah. So this is a very hard bubble wrap. I'll show you if I get that video. They actually showed me how that package that thing. I'll just show you. So 1 minute, I'll pause it and show you. So yeah, I just added the screen. So we can see here, the production is complete, so I'll show you. So if you can see this, you can see, right? So not here, this is a hot solder, but yeah, no, 1 minute, this is the final inspection. So this is the final inspection that they do, and I mean, now this, maybe the delivery part has the. So yeah, I'll show you the bubble wrapping. Yeah, packaging. So you can see how do they package this, and then this whole thing is compressed. So this is a very good part. Means I'll show you. So this is a very good part about this, as it prevents a lot of damage to your circuits. So I'll just open it. It's very easy to open this. There's no hard thing. I just teared open. You can just cut in or whatever you want, but for me, tearing open. So yeah, here you can see there's a little different plastic than here. This is bubbles, but here it is solid, so like it removes all the bubble. So it means there's a high amount of machinery, or you can see a lot of money invested for even packaging and delivery. So that thing I liked a lot about this PCBs. And yeah, good. So the overall cost of this drone maybe around 16,000 or what, for the cost price, right? And we are not selling it, right? So maybe around, we are expecting to be under 20,000 budget, but you know, that's just saying. It may go up, and it may be that we somewhere might stay under this, somewhere go up. So it's like not very you know, not very sure about this, so I just cannot remove. So they have made this very hard, I mean not hard, but yeah, very compact. And you can see this design is still here, that this one PCB was up and the others were down, so there's still, okay, yeah, still that mark of everything they have put in. So yeah, these PCBs turned out to be good. There's a 5 of them, and each one is a lot heavy. This board is very good quality. Everywhere that I had asked for solder patch or something, they have given this. So this design was actually done by the How to Mectronics, so thanks for that. And here this is, you can see we have made this thing DIY. Oh sorry, DIY. This is a my name and his, and this is the bro channel. So that's one, and it's heavy, and these are 5 of them. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is a very good quality. I mean, there are no scratches on the board, clean board, very. So yeah, I like them, and they're even getting this printed on it. So I, silk screen is very good. Moving on to the next package of this. So this is very easy to open. This is just staple. I don't know what happened. So I actually unboxed them, and these are very too small. Those were too huge. So you can see the size comparison. I mean, it's too small. But yeah, this is heavy, and this is like holding iron bars, and this is like holding a stone, a little heavy stone. But yeah, the copper quality they use, and I had just used the default. But yeah, this is very good. They had told that they would be putting some sort of number on this, and I had also specified this area JLCCC, but I don't know what was the problem, but never mind. I'm like satisfied with this even. So this is a very good quality. Talking about color, yeah, I'd like to talk of the color. So if you are time bound, like people give you projects and you're time bound about these circuits, like suppose you have an 8-day delivery, and so don't choose these colors, you just choose green. So if it doesn't mind what design or what color your project is, then you can go for these design, means these color based green colors, because see, you can see those green colors PCBs, because their build time is easy for them, because the green masking is more easier and takes less build time, whereas this these colors so had to be actually took a lot of time. It's, I think, took 2 to 3 more days. So yeah, as I told earlier, that they had not printed it on the front side, so that printed on the back side. Maybe I had put this specification here, over here, JLCCC, but maybe I had not clicked on the website about, yeah, I'm specific, so they must have printed it here. Never mind, that's not a problem. Only the front side is going to be seen, the back side is like, because we have the front side assembly, so we'll have to keep it like this on the drone body. So yeah, that's a good part, and they have a sticker on it, so I tore it a little bit. Never mind, I don't think we'll need this again. And they have all the details written, like Gerber file, internal number, delivery, order number. Is this order number written backside? Yeah, same is written. And what sort of 2x2 is there? I think some code. Even quantity, panel, even the dimensions, and the blue is the color. So that's very good. Sorry for my English, it's like a little I'm not telling my English is bad, but yeah, sometimes I get stuck. So sorry for that if you're having problem listening to me. And hope you guys enjoyed this video. So anyone who has not still subscribed to the channel, just go and hit the subscribe button down. And yeah, like this video and like subscribe, share it with your friends. And when we reach 1,000 subscribers, or maybe 1,500, I had in my tutorial had told that I'll be giving doing a giveaway of PCBs. So yeah, I'll be ordering those PCBs. I'm also reminding you, you just have to participant, comment down anything, I mean your name and your email ID sort of, so that we can contact you in case you're the winner. And just comment like anything you like about this video. So like I'll also do a tutorial about how to order on them, and I'll also do a detailed analysis about these PCBs. I mean, I have talked about the overall physical view. Now I'm going to talk about the technical view in this video only. Like, yeah, I'm pretty sure I'll do that just now. So yeah, the one thing I wanted to talk to you about is that this PCBs have a little shiny view, whereas these PCBs are a little more of they do not reflect anything. So that one is like a glassy one and the one is sort of compact and non-glassy. But yeah, it depends. I don't care for the physical look. The main thing is that it shouldn't have any crack, no problem in the wiring, no problem with the circuits, internal solder areas. That's it for me. I mean, I don't matter how they look, right? So yeah, this one was particularly for a gamer. So we had designed it in a way that we could control like the drone like this. And this is the receivers area, which is a pretty short one. And this is perfectly fitting me. I mean, the dimensions he gave, the person who actually runs the How to Metronics YouTube channel, he had given the dimensions, and I had not played with them. Means the dimensions, I did not actually edit them, and this turns out to be perfect. Like a PS4 gamer, you just need to add some keys over here and perfectly. Means if you know coding, if you know hardware, like you can make your own PS4, or maybe PS4, you can configure this for your PS4 through the use of code. So let's go to the software part, where we talk about what the design contains, what these PCBs have in them, what components and all. So now talking about the this hardware software thing. So this was designed on the EZDF. So both was from the How to Metronics site, and then it was edited by us. So wait. So yeah, this is the antenna or the NRF24L01 with antenna, and this part mostly contains this circle is a capacitor. This is also capacitor. These are all the other pins. For this area is for the Arduino Pro Mini 5. Here we have all the power pins, this thing. This is also a power pin. These are for the Arduino. This are also the A7 pins. So means if you want to access the A7 pins of the Arduino thing, right? So you can access it from here. Means outside pins have been actually rooted to this thing. And then we have here all these CH pins or whatever pins actually are for connections of other things. And this is the RX 3X pins. So all of them are going to be used, and these are the pins of the connections, and behind this we have the voltage converter. So this was the first PCB, and it's a good thing. Going on to the transmitter PCB, same in the middle, right? So in the middle we have the antenna. These are the two potentiometers. So we have the two potentiometers, we have two joysticks, we have the gyrometer or the accelerometer, I mean the gyroscope and accelerometer. We have four push buttons. We have two switches, two toggle switches, like tuck tuck, they go up and down. Then here we have the power. Here we have the on off switch. So here we have So the DTR pins here, I get it. Here are all for the uploading, same as here. So we have an uploader here that we have pins here. So we connect the wires, and then there's an uploader for this Arduino that we use to upload them. So this is a very good design by Howtomechtronics. And then we have holes here for mounting them. Same as with the receiver PCB, we have mounting holes here and here. So that is a three mounting stage, where if we here have actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, four on the edge on the corners, and three just aligned, one next to the first potentiometer where the bro channel is. Yeah, here the bro channel. Actually the text isn't visible right now. The second one is here, and the third one you can see. So that's how the design works, and all the commands, you know, right? This is a good way for not designing it on a GPB or the boards. I'll show you what is the GPB is, right? GPB. Oh, wow. GPB. Wait a minute. GPB. No. So, wait. General purpose board. So general purpose board usually is a thing made, I mean a board that is made out of copper, and it has drilled holes. So you just put in the you just mount it, all the components, and then you have to solder it, and you have to do all the connections manually through wires and all. So that way it's like, sometimes this complex wiring of all these, it's too hard for us to do it on a GPB, and it's more easier and more convenient to do it on a printed circuit board. So there's one more. This is all, they do it in factory. So if you don't have a costing of such high, you can just do one thing is, one thing you can do is just take out a laser print of your design. You have to do what design you need is over. You can use the Eagle software, and you can just download that file and laser print, take out a laser print, use a iron press, and take a copper board, and you just move the press above the copper. Means you make a sandwich, you put a copper board, you put that sheet of laser, and you press it. But that is just for a one side. Means if you have a single layer PCB, that's good. You have only top thing and all. This is a double layer because we have some intersections, so that all has to be prevented. So all this is a double layer that you can only make through these companies who make them. So that's how they do it. And for a single layer, I support that if you have a single layer, you don't want a cost of dollar, means some more than 1,000 rupees. So you just can spend what on I says the etching method. You take a copper board, put that lay the that printed sheet on it such that the print side is actually on the board, and you press it with the iron press, and that will go on that. And then there's a long process. You dip it in some solutions, you wash it, you do all the connections, you drill the holes. But yeah, that's good for one-sided one layer circuit board. I had actually started making circuit boards, means I had made one my own circuits through that, and then I only know what is PCB and what is GPB. So that was a good way where you can learn. And hope you like this video. So don't forget to hit the subscribe button, the bell icon, and like this video. I aim this around at least 50 likes on this. So do like. Thank you.